Yes, listen students, the next topic is 8.2 objectives of Security Exchange Board of India. This is page number 67 in our textbook. So there are four important objectives for the establishment of Security Exchange Board of India. It is the object of regulation of stock exchange. First one, regulation of stock exchange. Regulate the stock exchange with the help of rules and regulation, implementation of rules and regulations and the guidelines. So all the investments, that is purchasing and selling of investments, I mean the securities, take place in the stock exchange. So that should be regularly controlled. It should be possible, or it is possible with the help of the rules and regulations of the Security Exchange Board of India and other necessary guidelines given to stock exchange. So under no circumstances the violation is allowed. So that there should be a prescribed rules of regulations and guidelines is required for stock exchange for engaging of day to day activities, that is buying and selling of securities by the investors. As well as what are the rules and regulations followed by the participants like brokers and other kind of intermediaries, that should be followed. Then once the regulation of stock exchange by implementation of rules and regulation by the Security Exchange Board of India, then only the services that are provided by the stock exchange to all the parties is a fruitful one, or it's a meaningful one. The services are provided by the stock exchange to all the parties only meaningful only if it is followed by the rules and regulations and the guidelines prescribed by the Security Exchange Board of India. So we simply say the regulation of stock exchange is must and should necessary with the help of the implementation of rules and regulations and the guidelines by the Security Exchange Board of India. Then only the services provided to all the parties is a meaningful one or fruitful one. Second one, protection to investors. The functioning of stock exchange only based on the only the number of investors. When there is no investors, there is no stock exchange. That is why we say investors are the backbone of the stock exchange. They should be protected. So the protection of investors from the wrongful information given by the company. The investors are purchase and sale of shares and debentures and other securities or financial instruments from the company. So based on the information are given by the company, they believe all the information, what is given in the particulars, I mean prospectus. So the investors purchase the securities from the company only after go throwing of the prospectus is issued by the company. If there is any wrongful information, the investors by themselves cannot be identified. It is the duty of the stock exchange or the Security Exchange Board of India to identify the wrongful information. So not only the wrongful information, and also reduce the risk of delivery of instrument as well as the payment of the security. So there will not be any delay in exchange of instrument as well as the payment of money. So the protection of investors made by the Security Exchange Board of India by avoiding the wrongful information which are given by the companies. Then reducing the risk of delivery, there is any risk that will be existing in case of delivery of instrument as well as the payment, that should be reduced by the efforts that are taken by the Security Exchange Board of India. So it is another objective for the establishment of Security Exchange Board of India. Then check the insider trading. I already told you what you meant by insider trading. It is nothing but buying and selling of securities by the promoters and the directors. So insider trading means the person who are working in the companies, that is in the stock exchange. So buying and selling of securities by the promoters and the directors who have access to the confidential information about the company. So sometimes they wish to take the advantage of the confidential information. So it will affect the general investors. That should be avoided. So there is a need of or essential to check the insider trading, and the remedial measures also be required when and wherever required. So 4 points you have to bear in mind. So buying and selling of securities by the promoters and the directors are called the insider trading. Insider means who have access to the confidential information about the company. Sometimes they may take the advantage of the confidential information while purchasing and the sale of securities. Once if there is any purchase and sale of security taken place by the promoter and directors, which will affect the general investors. So there is a necessary for to check the insider trading when and wherever it is required. So there is need of effective measures or the remedial measures required by the Security Exchange Board of India to avoid the insider trading, to check the insider trading. Then control over the brokers. So broker is one of the brokers or the important participant who are dealing the securities, that is buying and selling of securities as a intermediaries. It is important to supervise or check the activities of brokers as well as other middlemen or other intermediaries in order to control the capital market. So in order to control the capital market, the activities of the brokers as well as the intermediaries check and supervise is an important one. So it should be possible or to regulate their activities, it was necessary the establishment of the Security Exchange Board of India. So the main purpose of the establishment of Security Exchange Board of India was to regulate their activities, to supervise their activities, to check their activities whenever it is required. So important to supervise and check the activities of brokers and other intermediaries in order to control the capital market, and to regulate their activities it was necessary to establish the Security Exchange Board of India. With the above mentioned objectives, the establishment of Security Exchange Board of India was taken place. I repeat once again, the four important objectives of Security Exchange Board of India are: regulation of stock exchange by implementing rules of regulation and guidelines on the stock exchange as well as other intermediaries, then only the services provided by the stock exchange is a meaningful one or fruitful one to all the parties. Second one, protection to investors. So protecting the investors from the wrongful information given by the companies and reduce the risk and delivery of instrument as well as the payment of security. Check the insider trading, buying and selling of securities taken by the promoters and the directors who have access to their confidential information and they wish to take advantage by using of their confidential information, that should be banned or checked, and effective measures to be taken against the insider trading. And the last one is control over the brokers. So there is a restriction, putting up some restriction on the enrollment of brokers as well as supervise or test the activities of the brokers and intermediaries to regulate their activities by way of implementing necessary rules and regulation and the guidelines. So with that end of topic 8.2, objectives of Security Exchange Board of India. So in chapter 8, what are the various topics so far we have discussed means? First one, introduction about the Security Exchange Board of India. Then 8.1, that is organization structure of Security Exchange Board of India. 8.2, objectives of Security Exchange Board of India. And 8.3, functions of the Security Exchange Board of India. So go through all the topics. This is very important. 2 and 3 mark question.